C++ provides a special multi-way conditional using the switch statement. This is a feature from the C language. Let's take a look first at how this works. You'll notice that I've declared four constants. They're integers, and I call them I1, I2, I3, and I4, and they have the values of 1, 2, 3, and 4, respectively. And I've declared another integer called x, which has a value of 3. And now I have this switch statement, which has a number of different options. You notice it has case clauses, case I1, case I2, and wherever x matches one of these constants, that block of code will be executed up until it hits the break statement. Break is a branching statement that breaks out of a block. So when it sees break, it comes down here to the matching curly brace, the one that matches the one at the top. So there's all of this as a block, and the break will break out of the block and continue execution after. And then you notice there's also a default. If X doesn't match any of the constants, then default is executed. And all of these have to have a break. Otherwise, the execution will fall through to the next one and it'll execute both of them. And so let's go ahead and run this, build and run. You notice that it says 3. And so that's because X is 3 and it matches I3, which is declared up here on line 8. And so that says puts 3, the string, T-H-R-E-E, and then break. And if I take this break out, it'll print both 3 and 4, watch, because it falls through. And so it's good to understand that. Occasionally you might use it, but for the most part, when you see a switch statement, you'll see breaks after each of the cases. Switch can be very handy in cases where you need to select a condition from a list of possibilities. The case clause requires a constant, so you'll need to take special care to use the proper type for this purpose. The multi-way switch control is inherited from C, although there's different restrictions on the case clause in C.